origami video, and today we are going to be making one of these. It's really cool. It's actually pretty simple once you can do it, and you can even open it up. And I'm hiding another.
What do you have? Another one in there?
Yep.
Oh my gosh, that's so cool. So they're like little triangular cube. I don't know, pyramid boxes?
They're pyramids, yeah.
Pyramid boxes, sort of, except there's more than, there's like six sides on them.
So here's how you make them and connect them. So first, you're gonna need three pieces of square paper, because you're gonna need three sections, okay? So I'm gonna start out with one. I already have my other two made. So here's what you do first. And first of all, if you want the color to be on the outside, you're gonna have the white side up if you have a colored piece of paper. So then you're gonna take the top edge and fold it down to the bottom edge. This doesn't exactly have to be a very sharp crease.
So it's just to guide you or something?
Yeah, okay. So then you're gonna unfold it and you're gonna fold the top edge down to the crease. So you just have to be able to see that crease you made. Then you can turn it and do the same thing. And so then you should have this. I'll wait till you guys can go and finish it. So then, you're gonna go and unfold one of them, doesn't matter which one. Then you're gonna take the corner, and you're gonna fold it down to the crease, and you're gonna refold that. So once I get there, I'm gonna go and do that. So then, you're gonna flip it over, turn it, do the same thing, but on the opposite corner. It has to be on the opposite corner. So opposite corner, I'm gonna take this, fold it there. Nice crease, tuck it in, and then if you do it correctly, you should get this, okay? So then, here's the next step. So then, you see the side, and there's gonna be a little point here. It's where these two sections kinda go in different directions. You're gonna take this, and you're gonna kinda pull it over, and I don't know if you would call it an ice cream fold or whatever, but then you should get this.
So you try and flatten it up against the top edge.
And then you're gonna do the same thing on the other side.
All right, so move your hands away. Let's see what it looks like now. Okay, got it. Great. Then what?
Okay, so then, the nutmegger said you start with again. You're gonna take this corner that does not have a crease on it. So see how this one doesn't have all this stuff on it? You're gonna take the other one. You're gonna take this point, and you're going to fold it down to the bottom edge. You're gonna unfold that. Then you're gonna go and tuck it into this flap. And this is how I do it. I just wanna unfold that flap, fold it back. So then, you should get this. Then, you're gonna go and take this corner right here, and you're gonna go and take this, fold it, and
you're gonna tuck it into the flap
again? Yes, this one's gonna be kinda hard because you can't open it up, but with some practice, you should be able to do this one really easy.
Oh, I gotcha, okay. Nice.
And you got this. Here's how you make them like go zigzaggy or whatever. So then, you're gonna go and flip it over, then you're gonna take this point, you're gonna fold it there, turn it, you're gonna take this point, fold it here, then you're gonna have this, you're gonna pull it up, fold it in half, and then you're done. So then
Whoa.
You should get this. Then you need...
What the heck do you do with that?
So then you need to make another three pieces, same way. This step isn't fully necessary, it's very useful though. So, once you have the three pieces, now you have to connect them. So I made all my pieces, but here's one very important thing I just noticed. They all have to be the exact same, no differences. So here's what I mean by that.
They all have to be the same. So you have to have all the corners pointing to the upper right and lower left. If you have the corners pointing, one of them pointing the opposite ways, it's not going to work.
It just won't piece together.
So all three pieces have to be folded exactly the same way so that they all look the same when you get to this step.
Yes.
Okay, now let's assemble it.
Okay, so first you're gonna choose two pieces, and here I've chose gray and black. So then you're gonna go and take this point, it really does not matter, but you're gonna go and take this point, and you're gonna put it in the black. So I just took this, and I just put it in the black. Okay, So here's the next step. Then you're gonna go and take your other one, which for me is the brown, and you're gonna go and stick it in the flap you just put in. So see how I just put in gray? Well, now I'm gonna go and put in, so that now I'm gonna go and put the brown into the gray, the closest one to the black. So once you do that, you're gonna, then you should have this. One of your colors should just have this little floppy edge right next to the one you just put in. You're gonna hold everything together and you're gonna turn it. So this flap goes in there. So you're gonna need to get this flap in there.
Oh, and there's the first corner of the pyramid I see.
Yeah.
So
then you should have.
So it looks like that with a pyramid in the middle.
A dining table.
Nice, a dining table. That so you can't set anything on because it'll all slide off the edge.
Nice. So then make sure that these are all really pushed in so they don't fall apart. And then you're gonna flip it over and you should get this, but with different colors. So then you're gonna go and take one point and another point. This part, hard to explain, but you're gonna take this part and you're gonna pull it over one of the things. So you're gonna pull it over. But see this point? This point is gonna go into this white strap that you just pulled over. So once you do that, you should get this. It's really coming together now. So then you're gonna go and take the longest point, which is the thing you haven't done anything to. You're gonna go and take that and you're gonna pull it over. For me, it's the black. So you're gonna pull it over and tuck it into that white strap. And you're gonna put the last one left into the strap, into the thing you just put in the thing.
The thing you just put in the thing, got it. So the gray is the last one and it goes into the last white open strap on the brown color.
On the thing.
For you, it's the brown color.
Yeah, it will be okay. Different for everyone. So then you got your ball.
What do you got?
You got a ball.
You've got a double, I don't even know what they call that. What do they call that? It's two pyramids that are smooshed together.
Yeah, and it's really awesome for Halloween candy.
Oh, so you can hold some candy inside?
Open it up, give this away at Halloween. Open it up for candy.
Nice.
So thank you all for watching. We'll see you in the next video, guys.
And if it was the first video you've seen of ours, please do consider subscribing. Be sure to leave a thumbs up. Do you want to see more origami videos? Leave a comment down below.
That's the mark.
Here, let me get a few just with these in it so that we can have a nice little thumbnail.
And
a shadow.